In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect your website with Google Search Console in the easiest steps possible. The first thing you need to do is search for Google Search Console on Google. And similar to what I see here, you'll see the first result usually saying Google Search Console or Google Search Console Tools. Just click on it to reach Google Search Console's homepage. Now, do remember you'll need to have a Google account, and it's advisable that you also signed in to your browser or into your Google account so that it's easier for you to log into Google Search Console. Now, the interface keeps changing over time. So sometimes you'll see the Start Now button, which I'm seeing, but sometimes you'll also see a button here which says Sign In or Start Now or something else. Just click the button that says sign in or start now, anything on the screen. Since this is the only button I see, I'll just click on it and instantly it will take me to the setup interface. Now, this is the first time I'm using Google Search Console on this particular email address. That's why I'm getting this screen, but you might just log into Google Search Console and have a completely different interface. But what you need to do is actually add a new property inside Google Search Console. And if you're seeing this interface, then also you can repeat the process. Otherwise, if you're not seeing this interface, you're seeing something else, just look for the hamburger menu right here. Click on it and you'll see something like this. In this, you can see add property. I'll just click the drop down menu and I can click the add property button. So if your interface is different, just look for the hamburger menu and go to the add property. So just for example, if I click this, you'll see the same interface pop up on the screen once more. That means you are on the right place. And what you need to do is add your website's URL here. Just keep in mind that you should not use the domain level verification. This might be a little complicated, although it works the same. The URL prefix is what we'll be using. In this case, my website is literally called example.com. So I'll add the URL here. And once you've added the URL, just click the continue button. And this is the interface that will pop up. Google gives us a few different ways to verify our website with Google Search Console. And the recommended method that is the easiest to use is this one called the HTML tag method. I'll click on it and it'll expose a verification code that you need to copy and paste on your website. This is the easiest method and it's absolutely, I'd say, the fastest method as well. So once you click on it, the HTML tag button, just click on the copy button. And we'll copy this meta verification code onto your clipboard. And once we have that, we can head onto our website and then start the process of adding this to our website. So I'll click copy. And once I'm here, this is my WordPress website. It does has almost no content. It has nothing set up. So I'll start the process of adding this piece of content on my site. Now, this can be done in a few different ways. You can edit your sites or I'd say websites files, but it's a little dangerous, I'd say, for beginners because you can mess up the code, mess up your site. And it is a lot of, I'd say, a problematic approach, or I'd say not an approach that I'd recommend for beginners. So in this case, I'll recommend using a plugin to do this. So we'll head into plugins and we'll install a new plugin by going into add new. And inside the search option, I'll search for a plugin called WPCode. And this is the plugin we're looking for, WPCode. And previously it was called Insert Headers and Footers plugin. So if you have watched a previous version of this video, then this is the same plugin, just rebranded to a different name. And you can see it's a very, very popular plugin. And what this plugin lets you do is add code snippets to your website in a safe way so that you don't mess up your site. And you can always disable them, edit them, modify them, and gives you a bunch of extra options as well. So it's very safe. It's very, I'd say, recommended for beginners and even for advanced users. They use this plugin all the time. So let's install the plugin. The plugin is now installed. Let's also activate the plugin. And the plugin is now installed. Let's go into the snippets menu by going into code snippets. And now we can add a new snippet because that's the snippet we've gotten from Google Search Console. We need to add it to our website. So I'll click the add snippet button. And now this is the place where we'll need to create a new snippet. So what I can do is just go here and select add your custom snippet because we are adding a custom snippet on our site. I'll click use snippet. And this will open up the snippet options, or as a snippet creation page. I'll just name the snippet first. I'll call it GSC. On the code type, HTML is what you need to have. Just click here in the code preview options. Just press Ctrl V to paste it. I assume that you already copied the code from Google Search Console. And on the insertion side, you have to just keep auto insert, site-wide header. No need to change any other settings. Once this is done, make sure to make the plugin active or make the code snippet active and just save the snippet. And once this is done, in a few minutes, your verification should be complete. You can go back to Google Search Console, refresh, and your website should be verified. That's how easy it is. As an alternate solution, you can also use All-in-One SEO to add this meta code to your website. You can see I already have All-in-One SEO installed on my website, and All-in-One SEO is a free all-in-one, or I'd say free SEO plugin that can help you completely set up the SEO on your website. It also has features to connect with a variety of different services, including Google Search Console. If you're not using an SEO plugin currently on your website, I highly recommend that you go check out All-in-One SEO and install it on your website. The installation is very similar. You go to Plugins, you go to Add New, and where I search for WPCode, you would just search for AIOSEO, which is an abbreviation for All-in-One SEO. This is the icon for All-in-One SEO. You see, I already have it installed. If you're not using any SEO plugin, or even if you're using any other plugin, you can easily migrate to All-in-One SEO and it'll give you a bunch of features. Now let me show you how to use All-in-One SEO to paste the same meta code to verify your website with Google Search Console. Once you have the plugin installed and activated, similar to my website or similar to my website, you'll see the All-in-One SEO menu here. Once this, you see this, go to the general settings. And inside the general settings, you see Webmaster Tools tab entry or menu entry. Just click here. And once you see this, just click to open this up. And inside the menu, you'll see an option to connect with Google Search Console, Bing Webmaster Tools, Yandex, Baidu, Pinterest, IndexNow, Microsoft Clarity, and even Google Analytics. And you can also paste custom code here. Since we are already connecting with Google Search Console, I'll just click this. And this will open up the Google verification code option, and I'll paste the same code I copied from Google Search Console directly to here, and I'll just click save changes, and automatically format the code to just save the preserved information or information that's needed. And once this is saved, wait for a few minutes, 5 minutes, and then go back to Google Search Console or refresh, and your website should be live. So once the changes are saved, just wait for a few minutes, go to Google Search Console, you can refresh that page that you were seeing, and you should see that your website is now verified with Google Search Console. Now do keep in mind that the verification process is not a one-time thing. You have to keep this active throughout the life cycle of your website. So if your website is verified once, just don't go and edit the snippet or delete the snippet, and don't delete the verification code from here, because that will de-verify your website. So it's a constant thing that you have to maintain throughout the life cycle of your website. So once you have this, just let it be, and you should have no problems accessing data inside Google Search Console. And that's how easy it is to connect your website with Google Search Console. Two easy ways. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments and I'll answer every single one. And if you're interested in more easy to follow along WordPress tutorials, then the subscribe button is just present down below. Just subscribe to our channel and like this video if you like it. And I'm Yuvraj from WBeginner. I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.